Hello children, good morning. How are all of you? Did you read the lesson, lesson 6? Did you like the story? Yes, we can't find our feet. What did the children do? The children, yes, dip their legs, put their legs in the, yes, the water, in the stream, and told Hoja that they can't find their feet. When you put the leg into the water, your feet will be under the water. And what did the children tell Hoja? Yes, told Hoja we can't find our feet. So the feet got mixed up. Not only we can't find the feet got mixed up. That means my feet with somebody else's feet and another person's feet is with another person. So it fully mixed up. And they told Hoja they cannot walk because they can't find their own feet. So Hoja said, oh ho, you can't find your feet. And what did Hoja do? Yes, he took a broken branch and what did he do? He put it under the water and started tickling. They put the stick under the water and then, yes, started shaking it. So it started tickling their feet and all pulled up their feet and ran home. So now they all ran back home and it was a big fun for them. And Hoja was a very fat person. He had long white beard. So we are going to do the exercise on page number 41. And if there won't be any question answers given from here, only learn the exercises on this lesson and read the lesson thoroughly. Okay. Now, the first one, correct the answer in each. Nazruddin Hoja is very dash. What is he? He is very clever. So, tick the first box. All the children dash Hoja. Hate, love, push Hoja. What did they do? Yes, they all love Hoja. So, L-O-V-E, love, the second box. Hoja is resting near the dash. Where was he resting? Yes, he was resting near the village stream. Fill in the blanks. Hoja has a long dash beard. What long he had on his face? Long white beard. What is it? White beard. W-H-I-T-E. So write there, white, W-H-I-T-E, white beard. The children crowded around. Whom did they crowd around? They crowded around Hoja. Now we have to write here capital letter. What is the reason we are writing capital letter? Yes, because it is a proper noun. Hoja, H-O-D-J-A. Hoja. Hoja. What is it? Hoja. Third one. The children put their dash in water. What did they put in water? Yes, they put their feet in water. F-E-E-T. Feet. They put their feet in water. Now, feet here, it is a plural form. Foot is a singular. This is a plural form. Hoja picked up a broken dash. What did he pick up? Broken what? Broken branch. Yes, he picked up a broken branch. B-R-A-N-C-H. Branch. Branch. Not branch. It is branch. Okay. B-R-A-N-C-H. Branch. Now, let's move on to page number 42. Take that. Read aloud. Read aloud. The sound of C. Ice. Sir. See the sound here, it is sir, ice, mice, not getting the K sound. Now you may be thinking why it is like that, because C comes in between these letters. It doesn't, you can't say ice, say ice, sir sound, mice, juice, peace. Now IR sound, girl, you won't say girl, R is silent there, girl, bird, dirt, shirt. Now, long sound of E, feet, you don't say fit, feet, keep, fleet, tree. and the group of words which is given here: keep the eyes, girl with a bird, dirty shirt on a tree. Now what are pronouns? We have learned that in the first standard. Pronouns, yes, instead of using the name, you use he, she, it, I, they, me, you, all these are pronouns. So take page number 43 and read through. Pronouns, which are pronouns? It, you, we, she, he, it, me, I first read it, sorry, I, it is I. When you talk about you, that means me, I say I. And give me, when I want something, I say give me, not give I, give me. You give me a pencil, I'll give you a pencil. That means I giving it to somebody, I say I'll give you a pencil. Give me, when I ask from you, I say give me a pencil, please give me a pencil. Okay, now read the following sentences. Nasruddin Hoja is very clever. Now first we use the proper noun here, Nasruddin Hoja. Now instead of using that Nasruddin Hoja, the second time when we write a sentence, we use he. If it is a male naming word, we use he. We have already learned this. For female naming word, we use she. For animals, fruits, birds, all this, we use it. Keep in mind. Okay, Nasruddin Hoja is very clever. He is very funny. Now when you are talking the second time about Nasruddin Hoja, we did not say Nasruddin Hoja is very funny. He said he is very funny. Next one. He is the word used in place of Nasruddin Hoja. Which words which are used in place of nouns are called pronouns? Words which in place of nouns, nouns means naming words, are called proper nouns. Sorry, pronouns. I made a mistake. Pronouns. Proper noun means like my name is a proper noun. Second time when you are talking about me, you can say she or you use her. See, for example, I'll tell you, Mrs. Insi is our class teacher. Now you use the name, my name, Mrs. Insi is a class teacher. She is wearing a blue sari. Now you do not say Mrs. Insi is wearing a blue sari. Now you can also say, now because when you did not mention my name, suppose you did not mention, so it's saying this is my class teacher. Now you can say her name is, see, you use, because I am the female gender, you call her, you use the pronoun as her. Her name is Mrs. Insi Lewis. Follow? And she is wearing a blue sari. So you are not using every time Mrs. Insi Lewis. You use the word pronoun as she or her. Now, which are pronouns? Let me clean this board. Pronouns are used in place of what? In place of nouns. That means naming words. The pronouns are used in place of naming words. Now, which are these pronouns? Yes, we said I, you, we, she, he, it, they. All these are, what is this? These are all pronouns. You use this in place of. Listen carefully, okay? Keep in mind. So for exams, when it comes, then it will be easy for you to write. In place of nouns, we use pronouns. These are the pronouns. Now, just look into the book. He, she, it, I, you, they and we are personal pronouns. It is the personal pronouns. For females, now it is given in details. For males, we use he and him. For females, we use she and her. For animals and things, we use it. For males and females, now for both male and female, you can say I. See, for boys also can say I. I too can say I, though I am a female. Then we say for we, a group of people together, it can be men and women together or girls and boys together. But when it is a group, we say we. Even for they, we can say in both genders. There is no gender change in it. And for you, when I am talking to a boy or a man, I can say you. You are come here for something. Are you come here for something? So the you is used in both genders. So write the correct pronouns for the highlighted words. The word which is highlighted, you have to write for that particular word pronoun. The first one, the rat is in a, there is a rat in our house. The rat eats, see, second time also, the rat eats bread. So what you should use for rat pronoun? Yes, it. So write there on the dots, it. The children play in the garden. The children make a lot of noise there. Now the children, it can be both girls and boys. So what is the pronoun used there? They, exactly. The man gets angry. The man scolds the children. Now the man, who, what is this man is? Which gender? Yes, it's a male gender name, male gender noun. So you use he, write he there. My grandmother is very active. Now here grandmother, it's a feminine. Feminine, what is it? Yes, naming. Naming word, noun. My grandmother stitches beautiful dresses. Instead of saying my grandmother, you say she. Okay. Now, me, him, her, them, us. Also used in place of nouns. Me. Give me. Give me a pen. Give me a book. Do you want a razor? You, do you want an eraser? Do you want a glass of water? So you, when you say, that is also a pronoun. Okay, right. Mother asked me to clean the room. See, mother asked me to clean the room. Swati can talk to him. That means Swati can talk to a, yes, male gender, that's why it's used, him. This is Rohit's doll. Give it, Rita, not Rohit. This is Rita's doll. Give it to her, because Rita is a girl, that is why you use her. This is Sharma's family's house. The keys are with them, because family means a lot of people, isn't it? Yeah, give the keys to them. Now correct the opposite, correct the options, not opposite. It's a mistake what I mean. Correct the options. There are two options given. Which is the correct one? You should write them. Right? Okay. Father promised to give promised to give me, tick me, a beautiful doll. Grandpa wants to watch TV. Give. Now grandpa, here it is male gender. So you use him. Give him his glasses. Glasses means spectacles. Dash should come to the park in the evening. Will you say me should come? Will you talk you yourself? No. You should come to the park in the evening. Let's move on to the next page. Cross the sentences in which pronouns are used. I think I shall come back to you with the next video. Okay.